And first, I'd like to welcome Rory Manning to the committee. She is the Park and Rec permanent member of the committee.
Hello.
So welcome.
Hi.
Hi. Thank you for having me.
So Dennis is scanning the group to show everyone who's here.
Facial recognition.
Yeah.
Running to the up.
Okay. I think we got everybody, Dennis. Okay, so good evening, everyone. Just a couple of things before we started, get started. In the mailbox last meeting was something from Dory Jamison that I'll pass out, and probably shoot the they were looking for $20,000 for permanent storage, but I think we probably should we can talk about this, but something to think about. Probably should have people who are requesting money come do a presentation to us. Rather than just kind of look at it. But we can talk about that a little bit. So I'd like to open the meeting, and I think the first thing is to review the minutes of the last meeting. We did we got snowed out last week, so we extended the meeting. We had scheduled this meeting anyways, and we also had scheduled a meeting for the 29th. So hoping that we get through everything tonight so we can not have the 29th. And that's the plan.
Yeah. Good plan.
So Kelly has sent out the minutes email. Rory, did you get those?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. And also in the minutes or in the email was a draft of the article that we can talk about tonight. I think it needs to be revised due to Griffin's theory going up from 63 to 75,000, whatever it is. So
I move the minutes be accepted.
Okay, thank you. Any second?
Second.
Second by Dennis. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? No. Excellent. Very good. Finalize the request for committee approval. If you look at the article that was included in the email that actually Jack did for us, and
I have copies if anyone needs them.
Yes. Please. Thanks for doing that, Jack.
Thank you. Do you have an agenda for me, too?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
I ran past Sue Mokun in the accountant. She's coming. Yeah.
She is? Okay. Okay. So I think just to... Everybody have one? Everybody have a copy? Okay. You want to see a copy? There was $18,000 for the community preservation expenses, which is the 5%. Under DPW, it was $33,328. Griffin's Dairy, we're going to talk about that tonight in a few minutes. American Legion, $18,210. There was one question that was...
on the prevailing wage, I raised the issue with Kenny Coburn, who was
yes.
one of the presenters of their project. He has not gotten back to me with an answer, but on the $18,210, unless somebody wants to increase it a little bit... They don't spend it.
Okay.
I think the prevailing wage is around $26 an hour or something for labor. I'm not sure, but it's in that area.
Why do you think we want to, if this goes to town meeting for approval, and it actually costs more than the 18, we can only spend the 18, right?
I don't know whether we should want to round it up to 20,000, and if they don't spend it, they don't spend it.
Yeah, maybe.
Or if they come in with a high amount before town meeting, we lower it.
You can lower it.
The problem is you can't raise it at town meeting.
Correct. Okay. So maybe I think 20 is enough. Or you want to do 22?
I think a lot of the cost that the Emory Construction Company gave them was for materials.
Okay.
So I don't know how much the labor is.
Okay.
And I know that my husband's the treasurer, so I won't vote if I'm not supposed to, but
you
recluse
yourself.
At the wage. What? Oh, yeah. But he said that they, I lost my train of thought.
About the labor?
Yeah, thanks.
Minimum wage?
That they don't have to, he didn't believe that they had to pay minimum wage Minimum wage?
No, prevailing wage.
Prevailing wage? Well, you know, I have a printout that I...
Because they pay the money, the Legion would pay the money themselves for this and get reimbursed. Do you know what I mean? Because it has to be done in a timely manner.
I think you looked at...
That makes sense.
Well, you had looked into it, Jack, didn't you?
Yeah, here's a printout from, this is the latest edition from the Inspector General as to how the public procurement law, the bidding laws and all that work. It breaks it down by category as to the, under $10,000, $10,000 to $50,000 and over and all this. And it talks about materials, the bidding process for materials, the bidding process for construction and labor. So I don't know whether it would appear that they have to use prevailing wage because it's a public building and a public project.
I would think normally we're insulated from this because most of the projects go through the town administration. And so we wouldn't have to worry or micromanage about this because they really have to go between, you know, town accounts.
Okay, those are excellent points. Why don't we just do this?
But this project is different.
Why don't we raise the amount from 18 to maybe make it 22? And then between now and town meeting, we'll get a definitive answer.
If we get a number that's lower than that, we can lower.
Correct, yep.
All right.
Okay, because we don't know.
Need a motion to that effect, Mr. Chairman?
Please.
So moved.
Second? All in favor?
Aye.
Excellent. And you're abstaining. Mel abstained.
Sorry.
And then the Island Grove Bridge was 35. We're okay with that. And community housing, I'm sorry.
Are we voting on that?
Well, this is like, we're not really going to vote on this, but this is like the recap from last meeting.
Oh, right. But we are going to vote on this one.
Yes, yeah.
We need to vote on the final draft here.
The final draft, right. And then we'll, the total 18 budget is 203 is going to be adjusted and et cetera. So I think probably the best thing to do, why don't we start with the Griffin Dairy Committee? And last time, you were here, you did a great job in terms of presentation. You refined the application based on some discussion in terms of the bridge and something like that. So why don't you, somebody come up and give us an update from what you've changed from the last meeting? You don't need to go through the whole thing again.
Okay.
To now.
Okay.
And if anybody has any questions, I think somebody had some questions about something relative to use.
Yeah, right, for the soccer fields.
Right. Anyway, so state your name for the record again.
My name is Carolyn Bates, 41 Oakland Circle.
Thank you.
And I'm the chairman of the Griffin Dairy Committee.
And with Carolyn is four distinguished members from the Griffin Dairy Committee.
Yes. So a total of five out of the seven. So we're in very good shape.
Excellent, very good.
Well, the first thing I'd like to do is to have you organize your packets along with my packets so that we can go through in an orderly fashion. So the first page would be one that Kelly just gave you, dated 3/17. That would be the eligibility page. And that's a replacement page.
Right. Everybody have it?
Okay. The second one would be the funding page.
So you're starting with page 10. That starts with page 10.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
Okay. Attachment one. And then page 10.
You know what we're going to do? Before you finish, we're going to number these.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Good. And then after that will be the totals for the reuse project. And then the reuse project broken down with the totals. And then after, these are the new section. You already have the civil engineer quote from Sean Hardy. A new one just came in, thankfully, yesterday from Rob DeRosa in Bridgewater, so that would be right after Sean Hardy. Then we have the original quote by Glenn LaPointe, which has Ann's writing at the bottom. It says estimate $15,000 to $20,000 per bridge.
Yes.
I'm still looking for the one before.
The DeRusher and the other. You're looking.
So DeRusher, is that the Verizon email?
Yes, that's the.
The Verizon email?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, that's with the end.
That's number five. And then what's next?
Okay, then after that would be Glenn LaPointe's original with Anne's writing. That's the second one that you've got there, Rory.
There's one that's good. That's probably the one that wasn't here at the time.
Get that one?
We have one, I have one that says estimate 12.
That would be the second one. There's handwriting, it should look like this.
I don't have.
I don't have that either.
No.
Was that in the original one?
It was in the original one.
All right, Neil, before you leave, we're going to grab that.
And make copies?
Copies and stick it in with the final one.
So that would be number six. Yep, so we're going to move on.
So how much is that?
That one was $15,000 to $20,000 per bridge.
Yeah, and what is his notes, same? No, what's his comments on the bottom?
This is Anne's writing, because she put in civil engineers down there at the bottom, because we're required to have civil engineers. Excuse me. So the civil engineers I put first, so that you've got that.
That's in the back of it, okay.
Okay. So then the second one from Glenn is $12,500 to $17,000 per bridge.
Yep.
And that's dated March 17th. That's the new one. There should be two pages for that.
So he's given an estimate based, a range based on, why?
On the size.
Why is his estimate a range from $12,500 to $17,000 versus like a?
$15,000 to $20, or?
No.
Why is there a range?
Why is a range?
Why is a range?
Because after reviewing, he wrote here, after reviewing the plans from Russell A. Wheatley, speaking with the Abington Building Inspector, it has been determined that the bridges have to be designed by a registered professional engineer with a stamped plan. All we can do at this time is give a rough estimate of the price of construction. All approaches to the bridges have to comply with the MA, Architectural Access Board rules and regulations, and should not exceed 5% slope to avoid having to use handicap railings. This estimate is based off of pressure-treated stock only.
Okay.
So there's that. And then after that, he gave an estimate for footings for the aluminum bridge. And I believe you had that in your original packet. It's the cascade.
I don't have that.
You don't have that?
This one here.
No, that one.
No, this one?
No, this one.
I don't have that either.
We'll grab that.
You don't have that either?
I'll take a copy of that.
Okay, make a copy of that. Okay. Give you that.
And that one too. Next one.
The next one.
This one is not from them. This is just an overall picture of, this is just for my information in case you want questions about it, that's all. So you want the original from?
Yes.
Yes.
This one, okay.
So I guess the Glenn LaPointe's final price is after the engineer stamps it. So he knows specifically that he's building in, they'll be in compliance with those.
All the regulations.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
So this may be one that we need to, we'll go back in a second, but we may need to approve a little bit more and then have it, and then if
have it come back down.
Right, based on the actual, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I was going to say that I don't think, I mean, it's fantastic work that you got the calls. And that's true, but that's because it's an idea of how much money we have to make available. But it seems to me, from Mr. Buckley's note anyway, that this is a project that's going to go through the town administration and is going to go through the bidding process, even though it may well be that these people who gave us the bids are the only people, right? Mm-hmm. But for us, it gives us a great idea of how much money you need. But actually, whoever is going to do, we just need to know, we just need to allocate the box amount of money, much like the Legion. And, you know, who actually does it? Certainly, because we're doing over 50,000, right?
Yeah.
$63,000, yeah, a lot of money. So that's going to go through the town, and the town's going to handle that.
I see what you're saying, okay. Everybody agree, disagree?
No, I agree, it's going to end up having, it's going to have to go through the town.
No, each part is separate, the bridge is one thing, the fencing is another thing, the gravel is another thing, the sign is another thing. So it's not over $50,000, because there's each separate items.
But they won't be bid separately.
Right.
They'll be bid together.
It'll be bid as one project, I think is what they're saying.
The amount of money you're going to get though, Mrs. Riley is...
We didn't have to bid it, because we got the three bids for the project, and each of the different areas are under $50,000.
Yeah, you're probably right, but I think Dennis's point is that the town actually makes the decisions whether you're right or whatever, right?
Yeah. I suppose, I thought these are the people who are going to do the work, and it's like...
So Dennis's point is we're looking to approve $75,000 or some amount. The town will determine the actual, if your bids are okay without having to get three or a bidding process, that's kind of outside of...
Does that sound right?
Wouldn't the committee hire the people?
If this committee were to approve the project as presented, $75,000, whatever that number is, then the Griffin Dairy Committee is responsible for following the public bidding laws, and the public building laws, we're not.
Yeah.
Right.
And as Ann said, it breaks off into pieces, a lot of the money is material, some of the money is labor, obviously, but they're all less than $50,000 each component.
Right.
But the law is pretty clear, I gave everybody a copy tonight of a summary of the law that the Inspector General put out just last October. But that's incumbent upon whoever wins the award, whoever gets the award, follows procedures.
Correct.
And they would follow, I'm sure, in conjunction with the town manager. I have a question, Glenn's bid was on pressure treated stock, and we're talking about aluminum, what are we talking about?
That's one of them. One is an aluminum one, a bridge, which the cost of that was around $15,000 delivered, but I don't know exactly where the delivery point is going, would be. But at any rate, that's neither here nor there.
Have you made a decision whether it's going to be pressure-treated stock or aluminum?
We would rather have, I believe it's kind of our consensus, and you can tell me if you're not, but I think our consensus is we would like to have composite decking. There's a bridge, a walking bridge, right outside going over to the Riley Field. We would like to have it be replicated at the for 20 feet by 6 feet.
So Carol, you think the pressure treated and that type of would be more in line with Griffin's Dairy rather than aluminum bridge?
Yes, but more even the composite, which doesn't require any upkeep, with the plastic railings, with the smaller railings for the wheelchairs, and we've talked about having it level. There's no arch. Mm-hmm. There's no arch going up to it, so that we wouldn't, as Glenn said if there's no grade, you don't need the additional railings. So we're looking at a flat, very, very definite pedestrian bridge. So
the bridges are all a guesstimate because nothing can be decided or planned on until we get the civil engineer.
Right.
So
exactly.
That's why nobody can give us an accurate bid. So it's all guessing and it's very difficult, and nobody really wants to give us a bid because they don't have a plan.
Yes, right.
The only plan that we have, a completed one, is the aluminum one. But that hasn't been approved by a civil engineer.
So you're looking for $30,000 for the bridge, including the engineering, and at some point you make a decision about what kind of a bridge it's going to be?
Yes.
Yeah, the Conservation Commission will have to have a say, too. You'll have to go before Conservation Commission on this as well, right?
No, they've already had their say. They told us where to put the bridge, and that's where they want it.
And that's according to the map.
Did you give them, did you give them a plan?
Correct.
Did you show?
They gave us a plan.
Oh, they gave you a plan?
They probably said.
You had the last meeting, this is on the Conservation Commission.
Really?
Where the bridges were gonna go.
Excellent.
And it was three at that time. Plus, it's all up to the building inspector. The building inspector may not like that bridge like that.
That's true.
So we may be moving to a different bridge.
So I guess the question to you is, $75,000 budget, does that give you enough flexibility?
Yes.
To get it done?
Yes. In fact, if you go back to the beginning, the bridge, we put in for $30,000. And then I broke that, we broke that down to the construction being $20,000, the civil engineer being $5,000, and the site preparation being $5,000. Because of the cement, possibly cement stations on either side to support the bridge.
I have a question about that number.
Sure.
If you said they were, and taking this into account that this is my first meeting and the first time I'm seeing any of this, from what I just heard, you said there were three bridges on that plan. So if you averaged 12 and a half per bridge on the low end of his estimate, that would be at least 36 to 38.
We're only asking for one bridge.
Okay,
so there's so much going on.
I think, Rory, from the time they originally put the first patch together until now, they've learned a lot in terms of more specifics. So I would almost recommend that rather than the 75, we look to approve 85, not to exceed 85,000. Because then you have a little bit of flexibility. I don't think, I think you're only going to spend what you need. So if we approve a little bit more, you don't need it. It's no big deal. But I think we recommend that we look at that rather than you get to the point where it's like 76,000, you can't do it. Then you kind of, we all kind of look like we didn't give enough foresight.
I like that idea better.
And Lori, also, that bridge is to support the people parking on Plymouth Street so that they can get them over there to watch soccer games.
Okay.
Okay?
Like I said, this is all pending me just walking in and not seeing this before. And I think what happened.
Well, you're supposed to be you're supposed to be up to date, even though you haven't.
I get nothing.
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
I remember when I heard I was going to be on this committee, I was all excited, but I was thinking, I'm never going to be able to do it. And the only thing I thought that in my experience was that it's a bit like the Finance Committee. And I was on a Finance Committee quite a while ago. But there, when groups come with an actual amount, we don't usually go over the amount that they ask.
Yeah, give them what they ask.
Often you go under the amount. Now, I think that I think the issue with the Legion is that they may not have looked into all the calls. So I definitely think you should.
Well, I think that. Yep.
But here they have a whole lot of projects to do. Mm-hmm. They're only going to do some of them. They want. How much is it?
75,490.
So that's that's three people's salaries, annual salaries. A lot of money, taxpayer money. And if they've asked for that amount of money, certainly we should consider it. I think it's a great idea. But I'm not sure if we should give more at this time, because they're going to come back. You're going to come back. You're going to have more projects, right?
Yes, we have two more bridges, more walking.
The only counter to that is that this committee is we're new, and we have a deadline next Friday to get the article in and stuff. So I think going forward after this, then we get the calendar is such that's kind of in our favor. Do all that stuff.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
It seems to me you'd be lucky to get it done next year anyway.
Mr. Chairman? I do not feel comfortable always upping the request. I agree with Dennis. I think that they come in with a finite. This looks like a pretty good budget, and I would prefer to go with what they've asked for. I don't want to be tagged is just giving the money away. I want us to be stewards of this fund and do it in a way that is reasonable and that the taxpayer doesn't get the impression that we're just giving it away. And we know it's going into the town, and that's all a good thing. But we still have to be cognizant that we are dealing with taxpayer money. So in my opinion, I would not be in favor of upping it any more than what they're asking for.
I had a couple other questions, Carrie. Do you know how much footage of the walking path you plan to do with the walking path, how many feet?
How long
is the path going to be?
It's going to go from the Plymouth Street parking lot down, well, north toward Patterson Street, and then cut across to the bridge, and that's it.
Well, then 800 linear feet? Yep.
We did 150 cubic yards of material to do that one path.
And John Stone would oversee that. Okay. And the chain link fence?
Yes, where is that?
Is for?
The chain link fence is for the protection. There are several spots. The original is to protect the houses that are on either side of the soccer field so that balls won't go into the yards, children won't go running into the yards, that type of thing. It's a protection for them.
Patterson.
Yes. And then also,
I'm no great fan of chain link fences.
Okay, but it's
aside from that.
It's something for the neighborhood.
It's a protection. It's a protection, yes.
Bob wire.
And also around the community garden.
The chain link is going to be around the community garden?
There is going to be chain link around the community garden.
Is that going to be replacing the fencing that's already there?
The animals get in there. That's probably going to get them out.
Yes. So.
Is that two-legged animals, too?
Is that going to be?
How tall is the chain link around the community garden?
5 feet there.
5 feet. For all of them, 5 feet?
No, 4 feet on the Patterson Street, 4 feet, and 5 feet around the community garden.
Is that replacing, is it a white fence that's around it now? Is that going to go around it as well, or is that going to be replacing it?
It's going to be replacing that. It's just chicken wire at this point. Which is,
so you're going to have 4 feet on Patterson Street and 5 feet around the garden?
Why 5 feet?
Doesn't seem like 4 feet is going to protect a ball from going over it. Soccer balls are going to fly over that.
They're more concerned at the town meeting.
Separation, that's what they're.
The woman that lives in that house next to Vinnie's old house on the corner, she was very concerned about kids running through to get to the field.
Exactly.
This will stop.
It's more for privacy.
Okay.
The other one is going to be behind the second house on the right hand side, the Taylor's house.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that is to keep kids, whatever, out of there. And to make them happy? Why isn't a 4 foot fence big good enough for the community gardens?
Strictly, we have so many deer.
Deer, really?
Yeah.
But deer, 4 feet, I was told it was fine for deer. That's what I have around mine, and
they go over my 6 foot fence.
The deer?
The fences at the house. You can walk over right away. You can come up any night.
My word. Okay. All right.
Okay.
I stand corrected. You have not mentioned mine at all.
Labor is going to be taken care of by the town?
This is all installed. All our prices are installed.
Okay.
And they've added fencing and fencing posts. Everything is installed.
Okay.
The same with the sign.
The gravel and all that stuff, the grading for the walkway, that's installed. Or is that stuff that the town is
installed? John Stone.
Okay.
John Stone is going to do the gravel parkways.
So the town will provide the labor for the pathways.
Yes.
And the split rail fence is going to be where?
The split rail is going to be at the head of the Plymouth Street parking lot and at the head and around the sides of the Patterson Street parking lot.
And the gates are on the Plymouth Street side, is that where they are?
The gates, there's going to be one gate at each, okay, so that for access to the fields for mowing.
Okay.
One would be a 12-foot gate and one's a 14-foot gate. And John Stone said that a 12-foot gate would be fine.
What kind of a gate?
It's a
Is it the chain link?
No, it's a swing back, but it's like a triangle. I think it was in the original of the.
Oh, it's just a bar that goes across and pulls the bar.
It's got. I have one here.
Metal, wood.
It looks like this.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay,
it's a bar. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yep. Sorry.
It's a bar.
Okay.
Okay.
It's a bar farm gate. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
Are we okay with the fence?
So to get back to theoretically organizing, the last thing we left on, which was the aluminum bridge paper, because we still have all these other papers that you said were organizing our plan to look like yours.
Oh, yes, and then this went back down into all of your original prices on the fencing and on the gravel. So there are three of each. The only one that we don't have three of is the civil engineer. We have two of those, and we have Glenn for the bridge construction. We have some others, but they asked not to be included.
So you're just talking about the footbridge being put in this year. So the other bridge, where you have an estimate in here for footings for the aluminum bridge, that's not part of this packet.
Unless the engineer comes back and says aluminum's the way to go. It's not their choice.
Okay.
That's what I think that's in there. Is that
yes.
right?
Okay.
Yes. We tried to cover all possibilities.
I get it, yeah.
Next year, you'll be back with step number two, or project number two.
So
plan.
Can I just...
Yes.
Excuse me for a minute. So then, if the footings aren't going to be needed, then that's $5,000 off of this bill. Is that correct?
I have to have footings.
Pardon me?
It does have to have footings.
No. It does have to have footings.
It will have to have, no matter what kind of
but different type. So
it might be smaller than.
So if it's less than the five.
So it's less than the five.
They don't get.
Right. It'll be come back lower.
Come back right.
Yes.
So I feel very comfortable now.
Good.
Good.
Good. Giving the amount you've asked.
Okay.
Because you guys have pretty much put in every contingency.
Yeah.
We've tried. In fact,
that's good.
Very confusing.
Yeah, it is.
In fact, I even saw the building inspector the other day and asked him if we needed to pull a building permit for the bridge. And he said, no, we didn't have to pull a permit for the bridge. So
other than organizing everything, is there a motion in order here,
well,
Mr. Chairman?
Hold on a second. Are we okay? Anybody have any additional questions relative to this? So you're looking for 75...
490.
So relative to the article, that would go from 63,200 to 75,490.
Good increase.
The total, the 203,877, 39 would go to 216,167,39, and the
plus the Legion money too. So. Whatever the number is.
That was like, okay, good point. Hold on a second, let me do that. Well, I guess let's take a vote for a second.
Yes. So I'll give a motion. I'll make a motion that we approve the Griffin Dairy Farm project at the cost of $75,490.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
We can label this phase one.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Phase one.
So good job, good work.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. A lot of back and forth.
Thank you.
Very good.
For people who volunteer, that's...
Thank you.
Can I just ask on this?
No, your time is up. No, go ahead.
When this goes to town meeting, do you present this, or do you expect us to talk about it? How is that done?
We'll present it. We'll get in trouble with all of you.
Just be there, that's all. Yeah.
I don't anticipate any trouble.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
After all these years, I anticipate no trouble.
Jack is on the record.
That's right.
We've been doing this for 18 years.
Has it been 18 years? Has it really? Well, nice to see you. It'll be great to see, I think, for the town, some improvements made and being used. So good job and a lot of hard work, and thank you.
Yep.
You can stay for the rest of the meeting.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Good night.
Thank you.
Okay, so if we go back to the article, let me see. What's the saying?
The draft article.
Yeah.
Yeah. The under the American Legion, that's going from 18 to 10 to 22,000,
right, what's that, 3790?
Yeah, just about.
3790, right?
Yep.
Where is that?
Under historic resources.
Okay, yeah, and that's going to 22,000, right.
So the two of them together will be 17080, right, Paul?
Yeah, so my thing is that, that the total then is gonna be 219.
220. 229.
Well, wait, we still haven't done the Island Grove.
229.57.
Yeah, we should do.
Well, I think we estimated that we're gonna put.
Does that sound right?
That's the estimate.
No, I think you're wrong.
But we're gonna vote on whether we approve.
We have to go on the whole thing, yeah.
On the whole thing, we're not gonna go each item.
Yeah, we're gonna go each piece, but then we'll do the whole thing.
We should too, and I presume that we're voting to approve the Griffin Dairy Committee.
Right, we did that.
And that we agree with that.
Yeah.
We, you have to take a vote on DPW, you have to take a vote on American Legion.
Exactly.
And you have to take a vote on Island.
We did the American Legion.
We did the American Legion, yeah.
Yeah, they're all.
All right, so let's, why don't we just, let's go back, so we're voting on the community preservation expenses of 18046, which is 5%, Jack?
Yeah, 5%.
The DPW playgrounds is 33,328.39.
Yep.
So let's take it one at a time, so everybody, okay, anybody wanna make a motion about the allocating 5% to our expenses for this?
I'll make a motion.
In a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, very good. How about then the equipment fencing for the playground?
I'll move that we approve the $33,328.39.
Second?
Second.
Rory, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Griffin's Dairy, we just voted on that, right?
Right.
Yeah.
That's 75,490.
Yep.
The American Legion.
We voted for 22.
22,000.
Who wants to make the motion?
You already did.
We already did that.
You approved it, okay.
We already approved that.
And then Island Grove, let's see, that's.
That's the next.
I'll move that we accept.
I'd like to be heard on this, because it's under the historic resources, so it's under our share. And there's three issues that I have here. The first thing is that it's not simply 35,000. This is the beginning of a huge project, a huge project.
Correct.
And it's, you know, so I think we have to be careful about this and think about what we wanna do with our resources, because we only have a certain amount of taxpayer funds. The second issue is that 35,000, nobody came to the History Commission, they don't have to. I don't know if they came to the Conservation Commission, which is in charge of that area. But I do know that selectmen have told me that they didn't come to the town management. And this is the beginning of a big project, so we definitely want the town administration involved in this.
Well, they don't need to be.
It doesn't matter, we definitely want them involved in this. And then the third thing is that, you know, 35,000, although it's smaller than the amounts we've given, except for one, it's quite a bit of taxpayer money. And I think this is definitely a project we wanna do, but it can detract quite a lot from our other projects. For instance, housing. If we decide to do housing, which is gonna be a huge project, this would detract from that, because this is gonna be a big project. Poor Mr. Tarokas got a huge quote the last time from this. And my third point is that there are other sources of income here. And one source, because I know it, is on the History Commission. The state actually has grants for this, and this particular project would come in. Now, the state would only pay up to 50% of it, and the taxpayer would have to pay.
Grants for what, the engineering report or the actual?
For the whole project.
Whole project, okay.
Yeah, but, you know, the taxpayer still ultimately gets stuck with some of the bill. And in the History Commission, we are actually trying to move forward to get these grants, and we're looking around, but we actually have to qualify, we have to do a certain number of things. One of them is to do an inventory of, you know, redo our inventory of our town. But this is a project that does have another source. It's a huge, huge project, it's not simply doing an engineering study of 35,000. And so, for that, you know, when we ultimately vote, I'm certainly going to vote against it because I don't.
I think the
discussion is
the discussion that when Sean Riley came in was that the who knows what the scope and costs of the fixing the bridge is.
Right.
So to determine what that might be, the engineering session has to be done first. So based on that, then based on the report from the engineering study, we'll determine scope and ultimately a cost, and then the town will decide whether, you know, whether it's where the sources of money to come from, stuff like that. But I think this is like the this is the first step, and I think it's a good idea myself. But that's why we have a committee.
To respond to one of Dennis's points about the state money being available, I think the town has to supply the initiative, and until we get a fixed cost, or at least some understanding of what the cost is going to be, it's very hard to apply for a grant, whether it's from the state or any other organization, if you don't have some hard numbers that you're working from. Mm-hmm. And this would give us the hard number.
That's a good point, and you know, it's good that Mr. Riley is behind.
Yeah, but this is like as far as voting, you know, people vote yes or no, and everybody has a different opinion.
Yes.
That's why there's like 9 people on the committee.
So what would you suggest? Because it sounded like a real good idea to me.
It is.
And now you're saying, you know, that maybe this could be done in a different way. Now you're saying the time frame. So what is the time frame?
Actually, I'm not saying it's not a good idea. Every one of the ideas that comes before us is a good idea. And I think it is an excellent idea. What I think is that it's not a good idea at this time. At this time, this is not. We have many, many good projects. We're going to have to decide which ones we want to put money for and which we want to wait. You know, the dairy committee is a good example of something that's actually going to go in stages and actually might be far more than the money we gave out.
Let me respond to a couple of your points, Dennis. Until you get a number, a hard number, it's going to be very hard to proceed.
Right.
Looking for grants or even letting the public understand how much it's going to cost in the final analysis. And if there's a lot of money, you can always bond it with CPA money too, if that's a decision this committee makes and the town meeting makes. But I think the bridge, as you know, is in pretty dire straits. Not only the railings, but I'm concerned about the underpinnings underneath. And until we get an engineering study, it's going to be hard to say yes or no whether we proceed or not.
What do you think about my?
I'd just like to weigh in. There's a lot been said. I agree with some of the points that Dennis has made, but I think that if we take the content of what Sean Riley presented at the last meeting, this is only a commitment for the study. And I'm okay with that, because that is something that this money for community preservation in the past, I've had dealings with these types of things. This is not a bad expense. Doesn't mean that we're committed to giving anything else or going any further with any other part of this project. And you're right, Dennis, this is going to be a huge project, probably in the millions, something that we are not going to be able to sustain on our own, because it would shut everything else down. So I would be on your side when that time came, so that we didn't let this project suck all the money out of the program.
Well,
but the bottom line is that I can be in favor of up to the $35,000 for just the study. And then from there, I would expect to see them to look for other sources to pay. And if they needed money to leverage, and it was reasonable for us to see at the time, and it's not in the millions, then I would consider that going forward. But at this point,
I agree on that.
I think that Jack is right on the money, and you, also the chairman. You cannot begin to start a program or a project without having a basis for what that project's going to cost.
But also, too,
and that's what this engineering study will tell you.
When we talk about community housing and stuff like that, we also have to do some type of feasibility study to determine that as well. And so I don't think anyone's questioning the need to do the bridge.
The difference between those two points is that while I can definitely see our group financing a housing project,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I can definitely see that. We just saw a newspaper article you were showing us that other towns have specifically used the CPA for it, and there's a definite need for that. know, your thing about the engineering study presupposes that we're going to go the next step of doing that too.
No, it doesn't. Not at all. It's similar to a feasibility study.
Why use taxpayer money? Just because you have 300,000, why throw 35,000 away on this project that you don't intend to finish the project with, when you can actually use that 35,000 for something else or put in the bank account?
But from my experience, is that they wouldn't, if they don't have hands-on on that thing, they're not going to have an idea. They're going to guess, and they'll never get forward.
But why do we do it? We're not going to finish the project. In housing, we're going to do it.
Right, I wouldn't think we would. I think when you get over a certain scope, certain size, it's way beyond this committee. You know, to throw a few thousand bucks at a $5 million project, a joke. But as far as helping them go, look, this is the initial one. You can't get anybody out here until you actually pay. The engineers aren't going to do it for free. And that would seriously help this project finally move forward. I got to agree with that. First, I was kind of wondering, what do we get for that? We just got words.
Yeah.
But if it wasn't such a stumbling block for them, like it's not the Griffin Committee, the peers, I could design that for them here right now. They don't need an engineer. But that's a whole other animal. It's a whole other. It reminds me when they went through all the bridges to the state and tried to find out, find out what they had to do. But honestly, I would say definitely it doesn't go any further than that.
No. My commitment goes no further than this. And this is only up to 35,000. I'm hoping that it's going to come in lower.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't think it will.
I'm kind of agreement where I understand that we're not going to feasibly, again, we get maybe $300,000 a year, and we're going to be banking some of it, mm-hmm. depending on the percentages we get off the taxes.
And we should be. Yeah.
We won't be getting a $5 million payout next year to pay for the bridge.
No.
I just think that taxpayers are the ones that are using this bridge. I use that bridge to go to swimming lessons every day for years. I fished off that bridge. You watch other people fish off the bridge. We watch the fireworks off of that bridge. I understand the commitment for the engineering study, and according to what Sean said, it's going to go to bid. So there's a solid chance that the bid could come in at $21,000, and we're going to get, I'm assuming, do we get that money back if they don't use it?
Yes.
So we're going to get that money back. It's if the bid comes in at 35, we're not going to get anything. So I have no problem, because I was going to ask, what is the breakdown of that $35,000? If that $35,000 is only for the engineering study, I have no problem backing that, just as everyone said, to get the project off the ground. Because as a taxpayer in this town, I use the bridge. So I have no problem if my money's going to pay for it, to just get the project off the ground where someone could then come in, the historical committee could come in, and apply for those grants, and get those grants, and cut the cost so that the taxes, when we eventually go to pay for it, either the town's paying for it, some committee is going to be using state money or taxpayer money that was our money anyways to fix that bridge. So if we can at least get it going, then the Historic Commission can come in and use that engineering study to apply and get those grants to then cut the cost at the end of the day.
Well, actually, we don't do that. How the Historic Commission does is that it's actually the Massachusetts Historic Commission that actually decides and does the bids and works out the studies. We actually put forward the project. Now, we're not in a position to do it this year, but we put forward the project to them, and they actually allocate the resources, and then they handle all of it, all the bids, the studies, the architects, the engineers, the contractors. This is supposed to look after, see the cement. So the state actually does that. We actually don't do any of that. The Historic Commission. And so that's why I think we're paying for a study that we're never going to use.
So how would it go? Would you guys have to then go to the state board and present that the bridge to be one of the projects they look at?
Yeah, we'd give it to the Massachusetts Historic Association. We'd ask for a grant for several million. They would come in and have a look at it, bring in their people and have a look at it and work out how much the money is. And then they tell us the percentage they're going to pay, and then the percentage that the town would have to pay.
So my question is, if this has been an ongoing thing, is there a reason that this hasn't been done yet? Is it there's other steps we have to follow before we get to that point?
It just came up.
Yeah, well, for the Historic Commission, it's never been very active. The last time we did an inventory was in the 1970s, 1980s. So the Historic Commission, State Commission is just beginning here in Abington again. But it is very active. This is a brand new thing, the whole CPA.
I know the CPA is new because I had to vote on it, but I was just wondering why. Then who brought the Abington Grove Bridge to us?
Sean Riley.
Sean Riley brought that to us.
Is the bridge a historical site?
Yes, yeah. It's either a historical site or it's a historical district.
Yeah.
Mr. Alwick thinks it's a historical district.
Sean made the point too, though, when they were doing the arch, because they couldn't apply for grants because they didn't have matching money up front. And this would at least give us a sense to how much money we're going to need, and if we have to put up some money to get a matching grant. But yeah, and I can see this going down the road with the Griffin Dairy 18 years before we get anything done.
Yeah, well, it's good.
By then, it'll be roped off.
By then, it'll be in the water.
It'll be roped off.
Do you have a time frame for doing it your way?
No, that's a very good question. No, I don't. You know, I have to be very honest.
That's the problem.
But I think this is going to be a study that's just going to languish. It's going to be so many years down the road.
Well, it's going to languish if
either way,
the commission lets it languish.
Well, no, we can never.
Or the community preservation committee lets it languish, or if the town lets it languish, like they did with Griffin's Dairy.
Right.
Yeah, we can't use the study though, because we can't use the study of the historic commission. Because what we do is we do a general grant, but they won't use that.
The point you make is that the study will languish. It won't languish if the historical commission picks it up and runs it and looks for grants.
They won't be able to use it.
You can't use that?
Why not?
Because they have to have their own people look at it?
That's
their rules?
Yeah, well, who does, but...
I'm sure whoever's hired will be a professional engineer.
And they'll probably consult, right.
I'm sure it will be accepted by the historical commission.
Let me do two things. Susan and Mel, you want to weigh in?
If the historical commission can't use this study, can they do their own study? How would they know what to spend?
What he's saying is the Mass historical. So Abington would propose this project to the big Massachusetts one. Massachusetts has their own people that they would send in to do it.
But
so they wouldn't take our study.
Understanding that there are 351 cities and towns in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts that are all going for a piece of that pie.
Yes.
So where would we be in that piece of pie?
That's exactly.
So if we get it started and we show a commitment and we can present something and say, hey, this is how far we've gone.
But they won't
and
now,
it. Maybe the
no,
the
but it might bump us up on the list for them
maybe
to actually
Sean,
say yes.
Maybe Sean can include who's going to bid this out to, include somebody that the Mass Historical Society Commission recommends as one of the firms to bid it.
Yeah. I should say, to your point, it hasn't been an issue in our historical commission at the moment.
The challenge, I think, the issue with the town has always been
to
spend money on anything would cause an override. Isn't going to happen.
Do you have any other questions?
Isn't going to happen.
Just
so this is, I think, I think it's a good first step. Let's see what it is, and then they can determine, you know, what's next. So
I just have one more question. If we spend the $35,000 or give them the $35,000 for the study, is that study usable?
Well, again, as Jack said, it's only usable if somebody's going to take it off the shelf and move it. And it has to be up to the historical commission to do that.
But he's not going to.
But I think Sean Riley is going to be the catalyst behind it.
Is he on the historical commission?
No, but I think he's.
No, but Sean Riley.
I should say the historical commission doesn't do, you know, it suggests.
They're only going to. The historical commission is only going to look at stuff that requests that come in.
But if the historical commission is looking for grants or some matching funds, this would give them a good basis
to go for it.
But at the moment, the historical commission isn't looking for a grant. And who else is going to use this? Who else is going to use this study?
DPW.
Because it has to be fixed.
It's Park and Rec.
Well, that's a good point.
We would have to use it.
It's going to have to be fixed.
There's two parts to the study.
To take it down.
The Historical Society is one facet of it that he can go to get to funding. I'm sure there's other funding out there that he's aware of or has thought about.
The study that they're talking about, there's two parts of it. Mm-hmm. If you call it a study, then it's kind of a waste of time because the next time you do it, you got to do it again.
It's an engineering study.
It's one, they can physically do it. They can x-ray joints at night. They can do that stuff to see if there's metals starting fatiguing and all that kind of thing. Same with concrete. They can do those physical things, and they can write a nice report on that, whether or not that's fine, you need to clean it up, and they'll give you some steps on that. But the other part of the study is actually, okay, well, let's say we have to remove all the, I would probably approach it that we have to remove all the foundations. And what is the cost of them designing either typical or designing whatever details we need to give it to a contractor for him to go out and bid it. Without those two things together, if the study and how, and the $35,000 is way more than a person would need to go out to site. I bring site engineers, they come down at nighttime and they review all the steel, make sure everything was done right, tightened right, and everything else. But you're right, if it was just the study, this would be why do that? But I really do, but the sum they're going for, they got from somebody, and it definitely, to me, it does include both getting out there, plus you have to rent special things to float out underneath the water. But
they're going to check underneath the water and all that. Well, Sean did.
In his application, the description of the project, hire a licensed consultant to inspect and evaluate the 150-year-old memorial bridge, including corrosion, testing of concrete, rebar and iron railings, to provide time with professional cost estimate for restoration of the bridge base and railings as a future project. I mean, he's going to do the entire project.
All the nuts and bolts.
Evaluation.
It's great. I think my main point, and this is the last thing I would say, is that we're recommending these figures to the taxpayer, to town meeting. And this particular item, you were saying that, well, the group that's going to do it is the DPW ultimately. Well, ultimately, the people who are going to pay for that are the town and the taxpayers, no history commission.
So they pay for the taxpayers' contribution to CPA funds,
The CPA fund will never pay for this. Well, they could bond it, a huge amount of money, they could bond it. All our money would go to that.
They could pay for the town share if, in fact, the historical commission got some grants from other places.
That's true.
It could be leveraged against.
But what you're doing is the taxpayer is opening the door to act in approving this and paying the $35,000, they're opening the door to an article in a year's time or 2 years' time for further payment on
this. No, if this committee doesn't recommend it.
No.
Yeah, that comes back.
No, you said the DPW is going to do it.
No.
The DPW could use the study if necessary.
Who's going to do the actual project?
We won't know until the project comes forward with the budget and we get approved.
If this committee votes not to fund the construction,
It's gone.
It's
out of here.
Yeah,
town
it's not
do
our
government.
Our.
Well, they can do something.
They can do it, but it won't come from our funds.
Right. It will not come out of the CPA fund.
But all this volunteers, it's just going to sit there and never get finished or never even start. It can't start. The reason I brought that up was I was on the school committee when we were looking, and that thing just died, just languid forever until finally the only thing we had to do was get together the money to have the architects and engineers come in and give us a real number, because everybody was just guessing high in the pie. Once we had that, then actually we could go to the state saying, look, we put up our dollars, now we've done this, now you can match our dollars. But that was that particular situation, so I think that's...
Well, why don't we do this? I think we've heard both sides.
The town cannot approve this project out of CPA funds unless this committee votes to do it.
Right, so
let's do this.
Chairman, I'm going to move the question, and I will move to accept the figure of $35,000, up to $35,000 for the study.
Okay, anybody want to second that? Second, okay. All of us in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed?
Aye.
Two, okay. So it's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6-2. Okay, thank you. Now I think, and then the last thing is set aside 10% to community housing of 36093.
I'll make a motion to approve that.
Okay,
second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, very good.
As everybody knows, that's required by the statute in Jameson. Set aside if we don't have any projects.
So, Jack, you can up this, but it looks like the total of what that we're recommending for approval is like around approximately 219.
229, 57, 39. I've got.
I got a different number, but you're gonna check it and.
I will check it.
And that's what's going in.
And the only thing I'll add at the bottom is that just the Community Preservation Committee will be sponsoring the article.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
And the balance carried forward will be something less than it is now.
Yes.
And I had a conversation with. So do you want to make a vote?
They want to recommend approval of that article?
I will make a motion to recommend.
All right, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, opposed? Very good.
Can I ask a question? The town meeting, does it get approved individually or all?
No.
They're going to approve the whole article.
The whole article.
I
would assume if there's some discussion on a particular component of this article,
I would...
Budget, take it out, approve the rest of it, and discuss that.
I would guess. They could make amendments.
I would guess that we would do a quick overview of the.
They can amend the dollar amount of the projects we approved downward, but that's all we can do.
Okay.
They can't add any projects.
All right, so that's good. So I think, so that's that. Okay, the Dory, again, Dory had submitted a thing in the mailbox, which we never got to last week. She was looking for $20,000 for like a 8-by-20-foot freestanding temperature-controlled storage mini warehouse. So I think, my recommendation would be that any requests, somebody has to come to the committee to present them, and we'll postpone this to a future date.
I don't know where that's going to be, what it's for.
Yeah.
Put it off.
Well, we need somebody needs to come, you know.
Does it meet our criteria and all that thing, all that stuff, you know? Storage for?
Document temperature control.
For document storage.
Yeah, it may, but.
But where would that be more for?
We'll postpone that, all right?
Yeah.
And I think Jack had Jack sent out.
He had a conversation with Sue Wolfman on the numbers for next year. And what the committee will have for next year is whatever is left over from this year, which will be something less than 157. It'll be around what, one?
About 140-ish, 139, 140, something like that.
So we'll have that money, and then we'll have the certified revenue from this current year that we're in, fiscal 17.
So it's about 75?
Yeah, which should be about 360. What we're appropriating money is on anticipated revenue.
Yeah, okay.
On next year.
Okay.
Right now. And then, so we'd have the money left over from fiscal 18, which is what we just voted on, 18. We will have the certified revenue from 17, which is the current year we're in, and they have collected roughly around 360. They will have completed that. Any state match we get in November,
okay,
that'll be added in. And then the anticipated revenue of fiscal 19, which is, you know, be about the same amount of money, 360 or 365.
So it could be close to $1 million in our pot,
so
which is good.
Can you, sometime next, when you get a minute, can you just send a recap of that
out
to everybody?
Yeah, send it out to Kelly, and Kelly can disseminate it.
I have a question, maybe Jack, you can answer it. I mean, our town auditor, we have a town auditor, correct, or is it a town?
Town accountant.
Town accountant.
Yeah.
Town accountant. We'll have an accountant or an accounting of what we have in each one of our boxes, and we could get that sometime soon. So that would include those three figures for 17, 18, and 19 once it is set.
Yes.
Because 17 hasn't been set yet because we don't know what the reimbursement said.
She can't give you the 17 number until the Department of Revenue certifies.
Certifies.
Which would be August, September, whatever it is.
Right.
So you'll have that money.
And then the
money left over from this 18. Fiscal 18 money.
Right.
You'll have the state grant, which will come in November.
Right.
And then you'll have the anticipated revenue for fiscal 19. So it should be
close to a million.
It should be a decent point.
Okay, and then, so any questions on that?
Well, and once town meeting approves these projects, she sets a separate account for each one of the projects that are approved. So that if Griffin's Dairy, whatever we said, 75,000, she'll set it up at 75,000 and change, and invoices come in, she'll pay them off that account. The playground money will be paid off that account. The housing money which just be set aside, she'll carry that in a separate account. The $35,000 will come out also out of the, she'll set up a separate account for that. So it'll be a separate account for each item, each project that we approve, and she will be able to take the money out of that when the vouchers are approved. Mm-hmm. Same with administrative expenses. She'll have sub-accounts within that.
Very good. Okay. And then let's see. You want to talk of edit, amend the community preservation plan? We did that, right?
Yeah, we had. I only had a couple. Did you get the? Did you make yourself a copy?
Yes, I did.
I only have a couple points. What we had up on the website was a draft, and that was really the reason for the public hearing last time to comment on it. Nobody commented, which is fine. But on page five, Kelly, there's some other community housing goals. See the second bullet? There's some X's in there. There currently is a waiting list of over 200. Okay?
Last time you said 315, it's now 200.
Yeah, this is just for local residents. Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
The waiting period for an elderly housing unit is approximately 2+ years for an Abington resident. If you're not an Abington resident, no chance of getting in.
Yeah.
Even if you are an Abington resident, you've got a long wait.
Yeah, that's too bad.
Yeah.
People will actually be dying on that list. That's too bad. That's not unusual.
No, but I mean, on the other hand, they get to die. So it's not too bad. People are holding on.
On page seven. The sixth bullet the third bullet under open space goals. Connection of. Stick the word "of" in there.
Did you make those changes?
Yes, I did. Yep, that's
changed. She said she made
them. You got that already?
Yep.
Okay. And in the two bullets down, you got
Completed.
The Abington portion.
Mm-hmm.
You've got that in there, Abington portion. That's in there already?
Yep.
Yep.
Oh, I don't know. The last word.
Yes.
Misspelling. Yeah, right.
Oh, Abby, done.
On page eight, I think the Plymouth Street play field should be the Plymouth Street ball field. And there was one other. There was a mention in there somewhere of the first bullet under recreational goals. I would take out a dog park because they're already doing that with private money. On page 11, Kelly, the numbers are not fixed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7.
Yep.
So go 7, 8, 9. So you have to renumber those. And on page 16,
found a mistake in there.
Guess not. I can't find it. So it's not the ending there.
Okay.
That's the guidelines.
Yeah, request for guidelines. Oh, I know what that
attach substantiating invoices, because you wrote the word attachment. Under this number two, attach substantiated invoices. Is it what has to do with the word attachment, or is there supposed to be an attachment?
Yeah.
The attachment.
I think I might have had the wrong number. Attachment page 16. It's attachment 5, and it should be attachment 5. For some reason, I thought it should be attachment 4. Because attachment 4 is a project status report.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. That's all I got. Just those few typos.
Okay.
So we're gonna make those changes, and it will be the final.
Yeah, make those changes. And
so we'll put that on the
website. Take the draft down.
Do we need to take a vote to adopt that?
Okay. I'll make the amendments.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Very good, excellent. Other business, I think Jack had, sent out, you want to talk about what you sent me, and I made copies for everybody, I think, regarding just best practice.
Oh, yeah. I emailed Stuart Sagnall, who's the director of the Community Preservation Organization, about what role we might play with the finance committee. And he's suggesting that we, once we finalize our vote, which we've done, that we should schedule a meeting with them and go talk to them about it and
Yep.
A little bit older.
Is that the same as this?
I think it's the same, that one just came along.
Same one, yeah, okay.
Right, this is June.
Same, yep.
You have that too.
Yep, same.
The same?
Yep.
One just says Gmail, one doesn't.
So I guess the, your recommendation, Jack, is that I think it's a good idea that we get on the agenda for the selectmen and finance committee.
Yeah.
And give them an overview.
Let them know what we're doing, sure.
Yeah, they meet together.
Finance committee meets on Wednesday nights, I think now. So maybe Wednesday nights.
And they're probably meeting weekly if it gets closer to the.
So I'll.
We do set up, let them know we'd like to come and talk to them in the back and opinion.
So we need like probably.
Schedule them, Kelly, and we'll go see them.
What do you think, Jack, like 15 minutes, 20 minutes?
Definitely, take more than that.
A lot of time.
Nah.
No, a lot of time. Good idea.
Yeah. You got my second email, Kelly? But I only put in the first two pages of the file.
Yes, but then I was unsure about what first two pages you meant.
Those first.
Kelly, did you bring the.
The third page was a question that I posed to Stuart.
More importantly, though, did you bring any brownies or cookies?
I did, next time.
I got a best receipt for the third page.
Okay. I see what you mean.
I suppose I would like to just say, Mr. Chairman, just a pat on the back to the committee, because I remember coming to one of the meetings and we thought we'd never be able to do our project for the upcoming town meeting. And now we've got quite a few interesting ones.
That's true.
For the community. And that's, and that's a matter of weeks. And I remember being disgusted at having to meet every week. And I think I missed some of the meetings. I was like, oh, I can't believe, why is he doing this?
Well,
but, you know, your determination.
Well, I think thanks, but I think the credit belongs to the people on the committee who did a ton of work. You know, Jack spearheaded it. Kathy did all kinds of stuff. Kelly and everybody. So you know, I think what we tried to do was try to speed it up so we could kind of get to the point where we can operate. We can meet like once a month and review stuff, like everyone else did, but the catch-up period was pretty significant.
Yes.
But I think we're in pretty good shape. So, again, congratulations and thanks to everyone for their hard work. And, you know, we're going to vote on stuff and we're not going to, it's not always going to be unanimous vote. Yeah. That's life.
Nor should it.
Next
year should be a lot easier to do because we're asking for applications in September, September or October.
And I think
it's much more leisurely.
Yeah, right.
Than this year.
And we need to, and I think you know, we get the town meeting and the word gets out. We need to kind of get a sense of what projects are coming up and kind of prioritize them in terms of what resources we have and what needs to be done. But the reality is, I think that nothing's been done by the town. And I've lived here like for, I don't know, 26 years, 28 years, something like that. And other than the school and Griffin's Dairy and a couple other things, the town hall and the library, you know, things just don't get done. So, you know, this committee, I think, has the potential, I think, of getting a lot of stuff done that everyone would agree needs to get done. So,
we didn't have any housing projects this year, and I think, you know, it's important. And I think once you get a new executive director, we have to. Pam's retiring next month, I think. So, get a new executive director. Whoever it is might have some thoughts as to how we can use housing.
They're looking to reach an agreement with Brockton to do a management.
Yeah. A lot of communities have teamed up with Habitat for Humanity to provide moderate income and low income housing, so affordable housing. So, you know, it might be something that.
I mentioned to I think Dennis, but and John, you know, the town takes property back for non-payment of taxes, so maybe we can get to the selectmen and say, well, anything that you take back for taxes, then we potentially can use for housing.
Sure.
So we don't have to pay for the land, the minimal expense, and that goes a long way to you know, if you figure the average. Lot in Abington is, you know, 130, 100 to 150, whatever it is, and more expensive things for bigger parcels that you would put multiple units on. Well, if we could ever do something like that, that would be a great way to to get to the end, you know?
Yeah, a couple of communities have teamed up with banks who have foreclosed on properties, and, and they've utilized that path to provide affordable
Good
housing.
Thought.
Does the Abington Housing Authority have any individual homes? Or is it just, they do? You do have individual homes, so you've done it in the past.
Yeah.
So that's...
Well, the Section 8 homes, you mean?
No, for elderly, like. I'm just saying for, just, do you have homes that are like, maybe duplexes or...
No.
So, yeah. And on the line that Jack and Paul mentioned, many towns do have that, that they have gone out and taken a piece of property and built maybe a duplex on it.
We have property that we own.
Yeah.
So that we could expand upon, and then we don't have to buy the land.
Right.
Right out by the school there. On the other side of the high school, is property we own that...
The unfortunate thing is that...
What?
Jack, you'll be familiar with this. The state and federal government now is not awarding major projects to housing authorities anymore. They're doing partnerships with private entities and getting long-term leases and then turning it over to the housing authorities after 30 years, which means they're going to get rid of the property when it's in disrepair.
Oh, what is it?
You know, but that's many, many moons down the line. And I unfortunately, it's the only way that we'll be seeing any new elderly housing in town if we do a partnership with someone who is a nonprofit.
Yeah. Mass Housing Investment Trust, I think, does some of that stuff. And
did you know I worked for Mass Housing?
I did.
As a compliance specialist.
We have openings on the housing. There's nobody.
I was a housing.
So the one that
Flatley's. Only two of us left.
Really?
John, is that where Flatley's the CEO? Who's the CEO of that?
The CEO at Mass Housing?
Yeah.
It was Gleason when I was there.
Yeah.
Now it's Tim Sullivan.
Okay. So, I mean, those are things we can kind of reach out and.
But I still have some
good
contacts there and.
Do we have a regular meeting night? What is a regular meeting night?
Well, it's usually it's next Monday night. Is that a regular meeting?
For housing?
For housing, yeah.
7 o'clock.
And when's our regular meeting going to be, Paul?
We're going to meet the first
Wednesday. Did I say Monday?
First Wednesday,
Wednesday
of every month?
Did I say Monday?
Okay. First Wednesday of every month, so we're not going to be next week, right?
We're going to postpone. We're going to cancel that meeting. Cancel that meeting
29th.
Based on...
First Monday or Wednesday?
Wednesday.
Oh, Wednesday.
So we will then meet April... April 5th, it looks like.
And, Paul, you will inform us when the Finance Committee and the Selectmen select the time for us to come forward. And it would be probably a good idea for us to attend, if we could, to show force.
Yep.
And,
I probably can't do the Selectmen because it's on Mondays and I work Wednesday, but I can't
That's fine.
The finance
I mean, it's just good to see more than just the Chairman and the Vice Chairman and...
I suggested to Paul that once these whatever projects get approved, that we should have a liaison from this committee, at least one liaison for each one of those projects to
Correct.
Keep tabs on them.
So I think based on like when they do them, you know, you're retired, right? I will be a week from Friday, so
I'm retired.
You and I can pick up a couple. And
I'm retired. Yeah.
Retired too. So people who are kind of retired have a little bit more free time than. Those who are working.
We can do that at our June meeting, I guess, because the town meeting is the end of May, so we'll figure out what projects have been approved. And get
I actually had a question about that, too. So as far as once we assign liaisons, when their bills come in, is that then, am I going to be paying those from their accounts, or is that sent directly? Do they send them right to... The accounting office?
Oh, it goes to the accounting office.
Okay.
Yeah. The only thing I think the liaison is going to do is to keep up with the project, see where they are, and keep giving us. And if they have any problems, being as an intermediary.
You should check with Sue Mokun as to how she wants to handle it.
Yeah.
She may want them to come to this committee, then go to her, which would mean you. So we ask her how she wants it to handle.
Yeah,
how she wants it to.
And they'd only be looking.
They're going to need some signatures on it.
I
think that this town will probably want to streamline it and not have another layer of bureaucracy to go through before it goes to the town. I mean,
Have you got paid yet?
Yeah, I just have been paying myself on our park and rec payroll, and then it's going to be given
reimbursed
back and put in that account.
Good.
Okay, good.
Park and Rec is going to get what?
I'm sorry?
Park and Rec is going to get reimbursed?
Yes.
Out of what?
Out of our...
I assume that 5%.
I told John Stone.
To keep it separate?
We can't, we cannot reimburse whatever monies we spent this year out of next year's money.
That's right.
He's on his own, he knows that.
Okay.
So if he wants it, he's got to get it this year.
If you have an issue of...
That's right.
Not getting paid, see me.
Tomorrow you get paid.
I have been somehow, so...
Dennis, stop a second.
Yep.
So, who wants to make the motion that we're adjourned?
I'm adjourned.
All in favor?
Aye.
Good job, thanks everybody.
Thank you.
First Wednesday in April, huh?
I'll send out the...
I'll do up the new one.